In today's video, I want to show you the latest updates Fitbit's made to the Charge 5 that includes the ECG app as well as the daily readiness score up next. Hey everyone, my name is Jeff, and on this channel I do all sorts of different types of Fitbit reviews, tips, tutorials, as well as other tech reviews and more, so please consider subscribing. And today I'm excited to talk about the latest updates Fitbit has rolled out, including the daily readiness score, and for the Charge 5, now giving you the capability of having the ECG app to take a ECG reading right on your Charge 5 tracker. And we're going to be going through all that information. You do need to make sure that you have your Fitbit app and your firmware updated to the latest versions in order to take advantage of these features. And if you're not sure how to do that, I've done another quick video that shows how to quickly update the firmware on your Fitbit device. That'll be linked in the cards here, as well as it'll be linked down in the description below. So make sure you have updated your Fitbit device. Now, from that point, if you've got your device updated, I do want to first start off talking about the daily readiness score. And the daily readiness score is only going to be something that's available to Fitbit Premium subscribers. So the Charge 5, if you've recently bought that, comes with a 6-month free trial of Fitbit Premium. So you'll have those capabilities. If you're on an older device, like maybe the Sense, the Versa 3, Versa 2, you're probably out of a trial period for Fitbit Premium. So if you're not paying for it, you will not be able to see your daily readiness score. From this point, to see the score, if you scroll down from your main dashboard, what you can do then is you'll see different areas to track your mindfulness, track your sleep. Right under that, you'll see here a readiness score. And if you're just starting off, you're not going to have a score yet. The way the readiness score works is you can tap on that, and it's going to give you a readiness score. It says here you've been more active lately and your readiness score is good. Plan for some moderate exercise, but don't overdo it. So when you first start off for the daily readiness score and you click into this, it's going to have you agree to some terms, and then you actually don't even get a score until after you have been wearing your Fitbit device for 4 days and nights. And real quick, as we do in all the videos on this channel, we've hidden Tinker, our little hidden robot. He looks just like this guy on my shirt. He's going to briefly pop up somewhere in this video. If you happen to find our hidden Tinker robot, take note of the timestamp or the amount of time into this video that you spot him popping up, and be the first person to let me know the timestamp down in the comments section below, and you might get your name and a shout out in one of our future videos, just like Donnie R. Donnie R. has actually found Tinker in several of our previous videos. So Donnie, thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoy the videos. So for everybody else, see if you can beat Donnie to finding Tinker in any of our videos, including this one. And we'll also put your name on our Tinker Forward Hall of Fame page. And from that point, then what it's going to do is gather all the information and then spit out a daily readiness score. And this is going to be based on three main areas: your activity, your recent sleep, and your heart rate variability. And right now what it's showing me is a score of 49. Now, the higher your score is, I guess the better, the more ready you are to do more active types of activities and fitness exercises, the lower the score, you know, kind of like the other scores that Fitbit has, then you're not quite doing as well. Now, in addition to just having 4 days to track all this information, to fully get everything all tuned up, Fitbit does say here, so I've got 9 days left, still tuning your score. Over the first 14 days, so 2 weeks, Fitbit tunes your score by learning how your body responds to exercise and recovery. So really, to get the full value out of the daily readiness score, it has to study your heart rate, your sleep, and your activity for 2 weeks, and then it really starts giving you accurate information as far as how it feels you're doing. And you can click on these different areas. So like activity, it'll explain here that yesterday you earned 23 zone minutes, much higher than your weekly average. Even so, your body didn't show significant fatigue, meaning that you can still push yourself today. And then it does show you more information on your active zone minutes. It says here, how does it impact readiness? Talks about when fatigue accumulates from moderate or strenuous exercise, it'll start impacting your readiness score. So it does give you a whole bunch of information here about what affects your daily readiness score as far as your activity. And then in addition to that, if we jump back, it also studies your sleep. So recent sleep, you can see your different sleep schedule. Keep it up. You've been getting enough sleep recently. Remember, not getting enough sleep takes a toll on your body and affects your readiness score. So it gives you all your sleep facts. And now this is different from your sleep score. Actually says here, what about your sleep score? It talks about sleep score uses the nightly sleep data. And then essentially that sleep is important. It's an important factor in your readiness score because it affects all aspects of your well-being. So it's taking all the information that it studies about your sleep and putting that into account for your readiness score. And then last thing is going to be your heart rate variability. And it kind of shows your heart rate variability during sleep. It's within the personal range. It shows your body's getting the recovery it needs to match your current activity level. So it's going to show you a whole bunch of information on your heart rate, and then it also talks about, you know, how this relates to your daily readiness score as well. It says here, a significant drop in your heart rate variability may indicate your body's experiencing stress, strain, or illness. When your heart rate variability dips, try taking a break from intense activities. Instead, go for low intensity exercises, stretches, or mindfulness sessions. So those factors between the heart rate variability, sleep, and activity all make up your daily readiness score. And then in the daily readiness section, this gives you recommendations based on what your daily readiness score is of different workouts. And here it's giving moderate workouts, so like a 15-minute at-home cardio workout, mobility moves and warm-ups and cool-downs, all sorts of different workouts, just kind of help you out based on what your daily readiness score is. And then there's an area here where you can learn more about the daily readiness. And I'm not going to go through it all in this video, but I will actually link to this page on Fitbit if you do want to take a look at all this information and how it kind of determines your readiness score. But that, I think, is a good snapshot overview of everything involved with the daily readiness score. You can use it on the Fitbit Charge 5 and those other devices as well. And it'll be interesting to kind of study this over time to kind of see how this number generates, and then base that off of maybe how I'm feeling and comparing to see, you know, if it's at a 49, am I feeling like I'm at a 49 today, or am I feeling like I'm at like a 10? I don't know. So we'll see how that goes. That is all the information for the daily readiness score. And if this video is helping you out, or maybe you're learning something, take a second right now and smash that like button. That's right. Take a second, smash it. I'll wait for you. Okay, hopefully you've done it by now. Thanks so much. I appreciate it. So next, we're going to go through the ECG app on the Charge 5. And to make use of this, on either side of your Charge 5, you have these metal rails. And you are going to be applying your finger and your thumb to these rails in order to take an accurate reading. And you can access this by simply swiping to the right on your Charge 5. And if you're not seeing the ECG app popping up, again, make sure that you've got everything updated to the latest updates. To take an ECG reading, you just tap to start, and this is going to open up the app. And as you can see here, it's telling me to put my index finger and thumb on the metal sides. And we're going to go ahead and we are going to take the reading. I'm going to hold really still. I've noticed that if you don't hold still enough or if your fingers don't make correct contacts, it's gonna give you an inconclusive reading. So we will see what happens as I am taking this particular reading. We've got our final countdown. 4, 3, 2, 1. Happy New Year. Okay, so data collected, and then it's gonna go ahead and analyze. And we'll take a second here, and now it says normal sinus rhythm. Your heart rhythm appears normal. If you're not feeling well, you should talk to your doctor. Don't change your medications based on this result. This app can't detect heart attack, blood clots, stroke, or other heart conditions. If you think you're having a medical emergency, call emergency services. You can download a PDF of your result from the Fitbit app. And then this gives you an area where you can learn more. If I click on learn more, it tells me more information about normal sinus rhythm. And I'm not going to read through all this, but again, just giving you more info. I'm going to go back here, and then if I am done, I'm going to just go ahead and hit done. Takes me back to the main menu. So it's collected all that information from taking your ECG. You can now access that on your phone or device. So let's see if we can access that information that was gathered from that ECG reading. And from the dashboard of the Fitbit app, what you can do is there's these little buttons on the bottom, today, and then there's discover, community, and premium. We're going to click on discover. And under discover, you want to find the area where it says assessments and reports. And you can see your wellness report. And then right here is where you can check your ECG, your heart rhythm assessment. If I click on that, it's giving me all the information here. Irregular heart rhythm can affect health. Analyze your heartbeat for signs of AFib and irregular heart rhythm. Only a doctor can diagnose AFib, but your Fitbit device can let you know if your heart rhythm has signs of the condition. It tells you what AFib is, possible symptoms. You can read through those on your device. I'm going to go to click on view results. So from this point, what I can do then is see the history of the different heart rhythm assessments that I've done. Here's the latest one, and you'll see here I tried doing one before that and it was inconclusive because I didn't have my fingers connecting correctly, or maybe I was moving around too much. But this one it was able to take. So it says normal sinus rhythm. Your heart rhythm appears normal. A normal sinus rhythm means that your heart beats in a regular rhythm. If you're not feeling well, you should talk to your doctor. So 80 beats per minute average. We're going to export a PDF for your doctor. So I'm going to click on that, and it goes ahead and it exports the PDF. You'll get a push notification from us when it's ready. This can take a few minutes. So I can click through got it. So then essentially what happens is Fitbit gives you a little notification that pops up on your screen. And of course I've clicked through it now, so I can't actually show you the little notification that pops up, but it'll say Fitbit has generated your PDF of your ECG, and then you can tap on that, and then it's going to need some sort of a program to open it. I'm just choosing Google Drive to export it into a PDF. And then from this point you can see your heart rate. So it was a 30-second test, and it actually shows you here second by second what your heart rate was doing. You can see all the different readouts from it, all the way down to counting down here to that 30th second as it was tracking everything. It does say how it works, and then it gives the purpose and performance, convenient way to detect AFib. This is not a diagnosis, but from this point you've got a PDF of this, so you can print this or you can actually show this document to your doctor or take it to wherever you'd want, which is pretty cool. You can save this digital file to whatever device you want, and then you've got the actual PDF of your ECG reading. So So I'm interested to know, what do you think of the new ECG app on the Charge 5 as well as the daily readiness score? Do you think they should be charging for it as part of Fitbit Premium? Let me know down in the comments section below. If you want to get more out of using your Fitbit Charge 5, I've done other videos, including my full setup video showing you how to add payments, set up your notifications and more, as well as giving you my top clock faces for the Charge 5. You can check out videos on that popping up in the cards here or down in the video description below, as well as all sorts of other weekly tech review videos that I do on this channel. So if you haven't yet subscribed, take a second right now, hit that subscribe button, hit that little notification bell, and you won't miss any of my weekly videos. My name is Jeff. This is Tinker Ford. As always, I appreciate you watching. Be sure to make every day awesome, and I will see you in the next video.